7 feet. Barren, strange fruit. Blood on the leaves. And blood at the roots. Black bodies swinging in the southern breeze.
Shit. Now, Officer Matthews, I've got a 10-10 in progress. 52 Lewis Avenue.
Strange fruit hanging from the poplar trees. Pastoral scene. Of the gallant South. Them big bulging eyes and the twisted mouth. Scent of magnolia, clean and fresh. Then the sudden smell of burning flesh. Here is a fruit. For the crows to pluck. Rain together for the wind to suck, for the sun to rot, for the leaves.
See you tonight. Losers. Okay, update time. You heard back from Jen yet?
No. I'm sure she'll reply at some point.
Let me take a look at the situation. Hey, Jen, you going to the party tonight? Dude, we talked about this. Could you have any less game?
I'm no good at this. Ooh, how about... Yo, Jen, see you at the party. Let me know if I should bring handcuffs.
Oh my god, you thirsty bitch. Here, let Lila the Love Witch work her magic.
Okay, just don't make me sound like a loser.
I said matchmaker, not miracle worker.
Hey, hold on. Let me check it before you send.
Too late.
Would be awesome to see you there. What? I could have texted that.
It's a good start. She'll text back, you'll see.
You know, I don't even know if I want to go tonight.
Oh, please. It's gonna be fun. You hate every party.
Oh, because they're all the same. Too many people, too fucking loud, everybody's wasted.
Yes, Sean, you just described a party. Well, the suspense is killing me.
It's Dad. Wants to know if I'm coming home after school. Jeez, I'm not a 10-year-old.
He just cares about you, Sean. Anyway, you should be happy your dad's looking out for you. Oh, it's Jen, saying she can't wait to see us at the party!
What? Really? Yes!
Told you I would work my matchmaker magic!
So what should I wear tonight?
A condom.
Oh, haha. Paying plenty of attention in sex ed class, I see.
Hey, lovebirds. Back from the loony bin?
Shut the fuck up, dickhead. Damn, your neighbor's an asshole.
Yep. Always true to himself.
Jen. We need to find a couch for your yard one day.
Ooh, careful. Last time my dad almost busted me out here.
Because you were alone? Your dad wouldn't bust me. He loves me. So...
Yeah, okay. It's Friday. Bangs for making me smoke again.
Oh, then I'll make sure you don't smoke any weed tonight. Deal?
Deal. Can't wait to see you baked as hell trying to pull this off.
Hey, perfect timing. Just the son I wanted to see.
Oh, sure. But I'm a little busy.
Did you see Lila? She said we can go to the movies next week. She said...
Dude, bug her, not me. You're not exactly her type.
You're lucky she puts up with you.
Ugh, jeez. Thanks, Pop. I feel really supported right now.
You're welcome. And now we need an objective judge. That would be you.
Really?
Hey! No fair!
Court is in session. Judge Diaz, presiding over the case of the last Choco Crisp.
Daniel is innocent, and so the jury gives him the Choco Crisp.
Oh yeah, I win.
Okay, back to work. I hear an engine calling my name. And you better play nice together, like you always do.
Hey, I have to go to work in my room too.
Yeah? Don't hurry back.
Tighten this. So, finally decided to come and join your old man under the hood, huh?
Yeah, sure.
I know it's not your thing, but you gotta learn a trade.
I'm trying. I just don't know what direction to go.
You're only 16 years old. You've got time to figure it out. Trust me, took me a while, too.
And you happy with it? I mean, your job, living here?
Of course I am. We're doing great. Maybe one day when I retire, I'll go back to Mexico, to Puerto Lobos. But until then...
Ugh, I've heard this one before.
I don't even know why I'm fixing you a sweet car for graduation.
Well, you don't have to. I mean, it's cool.
Are you sure you're my son? You don't want to visit Mexico. Don't want to have a car. I can't even get you into Rush or Santana. Are you going to ride the bus for all your dates?
Like I'm going on tons of dates. Not when Daniel's cock-blocking me the whole time.
He's 9. He doesn't even know what cock-blocking is. He looks up to you, Sean. Try and help him. It's what family is for. Things are kind of scary out there in this country right now.
Yeah. Oh, by the way...
Ha! I was wondering how long it'd take. You need money for the party tonight, right? Shh. Just be honest with me. No bullshit. Are you using this money to buy alcohol?
Yeah, probably. But we'll be partying at a house and nobody's driving home. I swear.
Well, everybody's gotta get home somehow. But yeah, you and Lila better not get in any car with somebody who can't walk straight.
Holy shit, 40 bucks? Really?
Yeah, why not? You did a good job on the lawn. Plus, I appreciate that you didn't lie to me.
Thanks, Dad.
Just be careful. That's all I'm asking for, okay? I know what kind of crazy shit kids can get into.
Did you party a lot?
Sorry. What happens in Mexico stays in Mexico. Now get out of here before I change my mind about that cash. And keep an eye on Daniel while you're home. Would you?
All right. Thanks, Dad.
Hey. Not so fast, Shawnee boy. Don't you think your papito deserves a hug?
Oh, lover boy. Just give me a minute. Gee, where did I put the... hold on. Okay, hi. Did you get everything on your hand list?
It's all in my backpack, yeah. Dad hooked me up with some cash, so we're set for the night, in case we need anything else.
Or if you and Jen need anything else. Ooh la la. Okay, serious talk. What are you gonna say to Jen tonight?
Well, I don't know. Play it cool, talk about the gig last week, get to know her tastes.
Oh my god, you did rehearse your moves for tonight. You're totally into her.
Sean, I'm done, look. I made zombie blood. It's, corn syrup and food coloring. Hey.
Hi, Lila.
Get out of my room, Daniel.
I was just...
Come on, man.
Just
bugging the shit out of me again after I told you to knock? Yeah,
but...
I know. Anyway.
Sean, you're an asshole. That's all you gotta say? You wouldn't be so uptight if you got laid. And maybe tonight's the night.
Don't jinx me.
Jinx? I'm your lucky charm, bitch.
Okay. So when are you coming over?
I just have to hit up the momster for the car keys and hope she doesn't make me lie too much about the party.
Hold on. This might be my masterpiece.
Well, yeah. It's my portrait. Jen just posted her outfit for tonight.
What?
On her wall. You should check it up. It might get your attention.
Hold on, okay? Something's going on outside.
What do you mean? Hey!
Look at my shirt, asshole!
What's the big deal? It's Halloween!
Hey!
Whoa! Sean, you hit him!
Get inside, now!
Sean!
You're dead meat, bitch! You and your whole fucking family are going to jail, losers!
What's going on?
Fuck me! Daniel, get over here!
Sean, is he hurt?
Okay, step away. Now!
Calm down, officer!
Shut up! And step back! On the ground! Now!
Hey, wait! This guy was beating up my little
on the
brother!
Ground. Now, hands behind your
Sean.
Head.
Sean!
This is fucking bullshit.
Oh, no.
Sean, what's
Get
happening?
Get on the ground, sir. Dad, we didn't do
Sean,
anything.
Sean, be quiet.
I swear.
Officer, listen.
I'm sorry, Dad.
Daddy,
be quiet.
You want to go home?
They're good kids, officer.
Don't move.
I'm sure they didn't do
I
anything.
I said don't move.
Stop this.
We didn't
Daniel,
do anything.
It's going to be all right.
On the ground.
Thank you.
No, man. We can't stop here. We gotta keep going. No pouting, okay? Come on.
But... my feet really hurt. These shoes suck. And we've been walking for 4 days.
What? Only two. Don't even try that shit.
And my back hurts from sleeping under that stupid bridge.
Yeah, so does mine. I was there too. Just knock it off. Hate it when you act like this. This is how people camp in the woods. It's not like being at home or in your room. This is a real adventure, right? So, come on, let's hit the trail. Seriously.
Where's Dad?
Daniel, come on. We gotta go.
Why isn't Dad with us, Sean? Doesn't he want to go camping too?
Yes, but I told you that he can't. I told you. Okay?
Okay. But I'm so sick of walking. I just wish I was back in my room.
I know. Hey, at least we don't have to go to school on Monday, right?
Yeah.
Look, everybody's gonna be so stoked when they find out how far you walked.
Really? Really? I bet Dad would be too. Do you think we walked, like, maybe 100 miles?
Probably 200. Feels like it.
Ooh, awesome possum. But next time, Dad better get me a good pair of shoes, like yours.
Dude, a Bigfoot doesn't need good shoes.
I'd rather be a wolf. Ow! We could be wolves.
Yeah. Yeah, that works. Just work on that howl. Hey, you know what? Let's see if you can walk the whole way without complaining once. Huh?
Like, you don't whine too?
I don't whine. I tag your ass and run. You're it.
No way. Not fair.
Whatever.
Okay. I'm a zombie, and I'm gonna eat you. Blah!
Carry on, my wayward son. There'll be peace when you are done. Lay your weary head to rest. Don't you cry no more. I rose above the noise and confusion, just to get a glimpse beyond this illusion. I was soaring ever higher, but I flew too high. Though my eyes could see, I still was a blind man. Though my mind could think, I still was a madman. I hear the voices when I'm dreaming. I can hear them say,
we'll be right back.
Pretty amazing, huh? See? It's not so bad here in the forest. Hey, look at those clouds. What do they look like to you?
I don't know. Cotton candy?
That's it? Cotton candy?
I don't know. What do you see?
Andrew.
Our babysitter? Where?
I swear. Look. There's his gross ponytail. There's his pointy rat face.
Oh no, it's so real. Andrew sucked. I'm glad we don't need a babysitter anymore. Ooh, I see something else. There's a giant douchebag.
Oh, yeah? Where?
Right here.
Right here, huh?
Wish we had more.
I know. Me too.
Sean, are you mad at me for what happened with Brett? I don't remember everything.
It's not your fault. Shit happens. Brett deserved it.
Why can't I remember? Ugh, that's weird.
Don't worry, dude. You were running around all day. You're tired out. It happens. I think we earned some serious rest. I could sleep forever.
Not on this ground.
Better than freezing out there. Right?
Way better. Now we have a real fire.
And a secure base. You did awesome today, Daniel.
Really?
Hell yeah. Yeah, you're like a real wilderness expert.
That's cool. My eyes won't stay open, Sean.
Sleep tight, bro. Hey, bro, wake up.
Sean? What happened? Where's Dad?
It's okay. You just had a bad dream. That's all.
Sean? Where are we?
Right here, in the park. Remember our amazing fire?
Okay?
You fortified our base, so we're perfect.
I did. You're right.
Go back to sleep. You need your rest.
But I might have another scary dream.
You won't. I'm here. Just close your eyes.
Thanks, Sean. I'm glad you're here.
Good night, Daniel.
Let's see. I think that's... Yep. And there's the damage.
Hey, look. Empty table.
Yep. Let's see. What do we got here?
This is a ton of food. I thought we were broke.
Not today, Jane. So let's grub out. This is our treat.
Really? You got me a Choco Crisp?
Of course I did.
Where are you guys off to now?
South, I guess.
Right on. Pro tip, don't feed the bears. See you later.
Whoa, that's a big map.
Yeah, hope I can read it.
Is this supposed to be Washington? I don't recognize anything.
Yeah, me neither. But we have to be somewhere in there.
Hey, kids. Looks like you're out camping.
Oh, yeah. Just going over trails and stuff.
Seems dangerous to be out here all alone. But maybe you're the ones who need to be watched.
Huh? What do you mean?
We just... Sure hope you paid for all that. We don't tolerate shoplifters.
Sir, we paid for this. And the map was free.
Well, let's go inside. You can show us what you bought.
No, thanks. We have to go.
Nope. You're going inside. Don't make this worse for yourself, kid. Or I will.
Sean?
It's okay. Look, our dad is waiting for us.
Okay. You can call him from our phone. Now let's go.
Don't touch me!
Don't do it, boy! Let go!
Don't touch my brother!
Hi. Officer Buell? It's Hank. Hank Stamper. Listen, I caught myself a couple of fugitives you might be interested in. Oh, they ain't going anywhere. Don't you worry. Okay, fine. Thank you.
What the fuck? Where am I? Oh, shit. Daniel. No, no, no. Don't do this to me.
Police will get those two straightened out.
Are you sure about this, Hank? I don't know.
And they'll be off our property and won't be our problem no more.
If you say so, then. Well, I'll let you deal with it.
Oh. Hey there. You finally awake? Sorry I had to secure you. But if you're innocent, don't act guilty. How's your stomach?
Just let me use the bathroom.
Nice try. But I know who you are and what you did in Seattle. I saw it in the paper.
Where's my brother?
Wish I knew. Little shit took off. I'll find him. Don't worry.
If you touch him...
You think I'd hurt a little boy? Guess you didn't have any second thoughts about leading him out into the middle of nowhere, though. That's real safe for a little kid. If he's lucky, he won't end up like his criminal big brother.
Just let me go. Please.
You're the reason we need to build that wall. You hold tight. I'm gonna go get your brother.
Scared.
Holy shit. Did that asshole hit you? Did he?
No. He tried to grab me. But I got away.
Okay. We need to cut this off. Fast.
How about these?
Dude, Brock. Did that asshole see you?
No way. I'm invisible.
Yeah, you are. Okay. Now we gotta get my stuff and go. What happened? What did you do?
I don't know. I don't know what happened.
It's okay. Come on. Come on.
Wait.
Shit. Watch out! Over there! Let's go!
I don't know!
Whoa, whoa! What are you doing out here, man? You almost scared the shit out of me!
You guys okay? You don't look okay.
That asshole! At the gas station! You're fucking crazy!
He tied me up in his back office! I swear!
Dude, say no more. I believe you. Okay? Shit's crazy out in the woods. Get in, you two. Hurry up before he catches us. Having a shitty day. Well, don't let it faze you, little dude. You're going to meet some amazing people on the road, too.
What's under the blanket? Come on, I'm not stupid. Daniel.
What? We saved her. We're heroes.
Guess we are.
So, what should her name be?
Hey, your dog, your choice.
Oh, cool. Let's see. How about Mushroom? She totally looks like a mushroom.
Not much of a girl's name, though.
Who cares? I'm sure she loves it. So do I.
All right. Mushroom it is, then.
Ooh, yeah. Thanks, Big Brother. See, Mushroom? You got the best name ever now. Mushroom.
Nice. I feel like I just witnessed history. You're on your way to becoming official road warriors, my dudes.
Sounds like you've been on the road for a long time.
Long, boring story short. I come from a family with money, but no soul. I took off after school and never looked back. Now I write stories for zines and websites, do podcasts, protest, try to make some positive change. Whatever.
Wow. So you're like all political.
Everything is political, Sean.
Man, that sounds cool. Don't you ever get kind of lonely?
Well, there's a big difference between alone and lonely.
Yeah. And you probably meet a lot of people out here.
That's right. The unseen side of America. Hey, no matter what, I just try not to get cynical. Otherwise, I'd be like my family. end of the day, we have to watch out for each other, right?
Yeah, you did watch out for us. Thank you. Seriously.
Looks like your brother crashed hard.
Oh, good. He always goes right to sleep in cars.
Yeah, and feel free to do the same. I won't take it personally.
What about you? You okay to drive?
Oh, yeah. This is my favorite time to drive. Traveling by night is kind of mysterious. Look at that. Oregon is like the edge of the world. Hey, listen. I know what happened with you guys in Seattle. Do you want to talk about it? I'm a good listener. It's your call. No pressure.
I don't even know what happened. It was so fast. It was all my fault. Dennett wanted to play Saw Me, and of course I told him to get lost, and our asshole neighbor was picking on him, and I freaked out. So Dad came out to help. Somebody called the cops, and they killed my dad in front of me. It's all my fucking fault. All I had to do was play with Daniel, and Dad would still be alive. I fucked up my whole family, and now we're alone.
Hey, it's gonna be all right. Take a deep breath. It's not your fault. You don't have control over all this stuff. You can't blame yourself for everything that happens in this world. You're gonna be okay, Sean.
I used to bitch about it so much. Now I've got nothing.
What is sure is, that's the past. But you can't look back now. You've got each other. And you have to move forward.
Why?
You may not see it, but what you and your brother have is the most important thing. He needs you. And you need him. I can tell he doesn't know what happened. Sean, at some point, you're gonna have to tell him.
Yeah. I'm gonna do it next chance I get. It's just... it's not gonna be easy.
So then, what's your plan? Where are you going?
Good question. I was thinking... get out of the country? Fuck it, go down to Mexico, you know?
Damn, I thought I was the long-haul traveler.
Should I go back to Seattle? Maybe I can try and explain everything. What happened?
You should do what you think is best. If going to Mexico seems like the right thing to do, then so be it. You're going in the right direction. You have family there?
Maybe. We don't even have family in the U.S. Except for grandparents we don't see anymore.
What about your mom?
No, no way. She's out of the picture.
But Dad, he always talked about this plot of land he owns in this little coast town, Puerto Lobos.
That's a pretty cool name. So it's gotta be great. Okay, so you've still got a long ways to go. We've shot the shit long enough. Time to hit the road. Listen, I'll drop you by a motel in a couple of hours. You guys could use some time to yourselves. Looks like these two are getting along. It's good to see him like that. Well, I got you that room.
Seriously?
It's only a room, no big deal. Look, I had tough times when I started out. And some strangers saved my life.
Thank you.
Now's my turn to help someone. It's right there, room 10. On the second floor. Listen. I don't want to freak you out, okay, but you have to be twice as careful now. I know it's easier said than done, but you can always get a burner later. Trust me. And Sean, talk to Daniel. He deserves
Brody, you're not leaving, are you?
Yes, I am, but not until Santa Brody gives you a goodbye gift. Ta-da! I mean... Ho, ho, ho. And don't you dare argue about it. I'll leave it right here if you do.
Okay, you win. Thanks, Brody. Feels good. Here, looks like it's yours now.
As always.
Hold on. I didn't forget you. I've had it since my first road trip. And it's always kept me safe. Now it's yours.
Cool. Do you think it's okay if she wears it? Like, our official guard dog?
Sure. It's your bandana now. Okay. Time for me to hit the road again. Hey, don't look so sad. You can contact me on my blog, A Tribe Called West. So, you better keep me posted when you can, okay?
We will. Thanks again, Brody.
Ah, bro hug.
Wish you could stay with us.
Me too, kid. Sorry, I'll probably think of a better goodbye when I'm on the road, but until then, take care, my dudes.
I'm gonna miss him.
Me too. Okay. Time to hit the sack.
Ooh! Check it out! It even has a bathtub!
Good. I'm gonna throw you in, cave boy.
We can watch TV, too! And there's a balcony! Whoa, this is nice. And warm. This bed is soft. What about this one? Not bad. But too far from the TV. Can I take the one in front of the TV? Huh? Wanna play it over rock, paper, scissors?
Oh, there's no way you can beat me, but... Ready?
I am so ready to beat you. Aw, come on. Not fair.
You lost, man. What's not fair?
I wanted that bed.
Take it.
For real?
I don't really care.
Awesome.
They're the same, you know?
Yeah, but I like this one better.
Daniel. Oh, fuck. Oh, my God. Daniel! What's happening? Daniel, calm down.
You lied! Dad! Your dad is dead! Why?
Calm down, Daniel. Let's just talk, please.
You knew Dad was dead! You knew it! Why did you lie to me?
I was scared, Daniel. I didn't know what to say.
You should have told me.
I couldn't believe it either. I didn't mean to.
I hate you. Not my brother.
Don't say that. I know I messed up everything. We're gonna get through this.
Don't touch me.
Daniel, please!
Oh.
Shh. It's okay.
I want Dad.
Me too.
Told me we were gonna see Dad.
I'm sorry. I just...
Just don't lie to me ever again. Ever.
I promise.
I'm serious, Sean.
I know. Me too, Danny.
What are we gonna do without him?
Shh. It's gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay.
Sean. Am I a monster?
Nothing is wrong with you. You're different.
Okay. What are we gonna do now?
I was thinking maybe we could go to Puerto Lobos.
where Dad grew up, you know?
Yeah, I guess.
It'll be fine, Daniel. There's nothing we can't do. As long as we're together.
Can you tell me a story? Like he did?
I'm not as good as him. He used to tell me bedtime stories, too. Once upon a time, in a wild, wild world, there were two wolf brothers living in their home lair with their papa wolf. They all lived happily together. But one day, hunters took their dad away. Forever. So now the brothers were alone. And they had to find a new home. They started a journey through the great big forest.